Hello everyone, welcome to NIRH channel. Dear students, in the previous class we discussed about basic proportionality theorem. I told it is very important theorem. Now see, in this theorem we have seen if a line is drawn parallel to one side of the triangle to intersect the other two sides of distinct point, that is A and B, then the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. Correct? Now line AB is parallel to the third side, means now to intersect the other two sides at A and B of side PQ and PR, now these ratios are in the same proportional. It means we proved that in the previous class PA divided by AP, AQ is equal to PB divided by BR. Now we proved in the last class. Now see, either the AB is parallel to QR, even the PQ divided by PA. See that, you can say that, we'll prove that again. See, one more point about the corollary, means one more theorem here. Now either these are divided in the same ratio, means we can write, what you can prove here, PQ divided by AP or PA is equal to PR divided by PB. This is a PA. See here children, either AB is parallel to QR, means we proved that PA divided by AQ and PB divided by BR, the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. See, even you can say that PQ divided by PA and PR divided by PB, these ratios are also divided in the same proportional. Now see, you will prove that. Now one more, what you can say, that is PQ divided by AQ is equal to PR divided by BR. See that these ratios are also in the same proportional. We'll see that one by one how it is. Now by basic proportionality theorem, now what you proved, that is PA divided by AQ is equal to PB divided by BR. Now already proved this one in the last class. Now write the reciprocal. By writing reciprocal, EQ divided by PA is equal to BR divided by PB. Correct. Now adding one on both sides. See what you get now. On both sides. See what you'll get. AQ divided by PA plus 1 is equal to, on the RHS side, BR divided by PB plus 1. Correct. Then see, find the LCM. Now after finding the LCM, see that PA into 1, PA. Now AQ plus PA into 1, PA whole divided by PA. Correct. This is after finding the LCM. Either you can find the like this also. There is no denominator, means 1 will be there. Now LCM of the PA and 1, PA. Then here PA, 1 za, PA. Here 1, PA, 1 za, PA. So after adding, we will get the this one. Correct. Now the direct method I done here. What is that direct method? Denominator into whole number plus numerator divided by denominator. Similar is equal to here, BR plus PB whole divided by PB. Correct. Now see, AQ plus PA means, see here, AQ plus PA means which side? Yes. What is that, which side here? PQ. divided by PA. Correct, children. So is equal to BR plus PB. BR plus PB means which side? PR. PR divided by PB. Correct. Now this one, what you proved here? See here, first one, PQ divided by PA. Correct. Means you proved the first one, this one. Now next we'll see the this one. Now see, remember children, either the AB is drawn the parallel to the QR, means we can write the side PA divided by PQ and PR, PB divided by PR. Similar, PQ divided by PA and PR divided by PB. Even you can write PQ divided by AQ and PR divided by PR also. See, we'll prove the second one now. Now, what you put there first, same first again, you have to take the PA, correct? PA divided by AQ is equal to PB divided by BR, correct? Now, yes. Now, adding, same again, adding 1. Before what we done? After writing the reciprocal, first we written the reciprocal, then we added the 1 on the both side. Here directly you have to add the 1 on the both side. Adding 1 on both sides, we get, see what you get? PA divided by AQ plus 1 is equal to PB divided by BR plus 1. Now find the LCM. What will get the LCM here? PA, correct, plus AQ divided by AQ is equal to PB plus BR whole divided by BR. Correct, children. So is equal to, now PA plus AQ means, see in the diagram, PA plus AQ means again, what is that? PQ divided by AQ is equal to PB plus BR. PB plus BR means, what is that? PR divided by, what is that? BR. Correct. Now see that PQ divided by AQ and PR divided by BR. Hence proved. See these theorems, see that very important. Why I done these two extra means, while solving the exercise, you have to require these points. If you know these two points, means you can easily find the unknown value of the given sides of the triangle. I hope you understood, children. See, clearly you have to see that this is a very simple method is there. Just by writing the reciprocal and add the one on the both side, we'll get the first answer. Then afterwards, directly you have to add the one on the both side, we'll get the another proof here. Clear, children? See the exercise. One example you'll see in the exercise. See the students, exercise number 6.2, based on the basic proportionality theorem. First main is, in figure 6.17, first two figures they given, first and second, DE is parallel to BC. In the first diagram they given, DE is parallel to BC. Find EC in first one. Find the, they ask the question to EC. By seeing the diagram, you'll get that here, DE is parallel to BC they given. They ask the question to find the EC in first and AD in second. AD, see where is that? AD in the second figure. They given the measurement here. They given DE is parallel to BC and DE is parallel to BC. In both diagram, they given parallel sides here. Now by using basic proportionality theorem, you have to find the unknown values. See the diagram, you'll get the idea. So first we'll see in a triangle. In a triangle ABC. See what they given, triangle ABC. See the carefully, student. Now DE, they given DE is parallel to BC. Correct? DE is parallel to BC they given. Then see, student, DE is parallel to BC means the based on the basic proportionality theorem. Now the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. We learn that is the AD divided by DB is equal to AE divided by EC. Correct. So I will write here. What you can write here? AD divided by DB. AD divided by DB is equal to that side. AE divided by EC. Why you can write like this? By basic proportionality theorem. Understood, children? Because by basic proportionality theorem, they given D is parallel to BC means the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. Correct. They given the value. AD value, see how much they given here. AD is 1.5 centimeter divided by DB. DB how much is there? 3 centimeter. 3 centimeter is equal to then AE. AE how much is there? 1 centimeter divided by EC, we don't know, right, as it is. EC centimeter. Now see children, three values you know that. They ask the question to find the EC. Now do the cross multiplication. E into 1.5 centimeter, EC into 1.5 centimeter, EC is EC 1.5 into EC is equal to 3 centimeter. Correct, student? Now EC is equal to 3 centimeter divided by 1.5 centimeter. Therefore, EC is equal to, cancel this one, now remove this decimal point, you can put the 10 up. See how to write that direct here. See how to divide, either it is decimal number is there means, now 3 by 1.5 centimeter. Remove this decimal point, put the 10 up, because after decimal point on the right hand side only one digit, so you can do like this. So 30 divided by 15 centimeter. Therefore, EC is equal to 15 ones are 15 twos are. So how much centimeter is there? EC is equal to 2 centimeter. I hope you understood, students. See how you got the EC is equal to 2 centimeter. Now similar second diagram. See this one now. So very simple is there. Here they given AD is unknown. Now DB they given. EC they given, AE also they given. They ask the question to find the AD. By using the proportionality theorem, you can find that AD. Now, this second one is the homework for you. In the next class, we'll see the remaining example. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.